Okie dokie, folks. So we're casting the OBBL game. Humans versus Pro Elves. Human drive, and looks like that Broggy was trying to get that hit on the Strength 4 Pro Elf, and it's cost him the ball for the time being. As for Dark Elves, yes, well, I don't know. Can't speak specifically to them now, but hey, what can go wrong? Just don't roll ones, right? Oh yeah, let's turn the skills down a little bit here. So we're probably going to see the strength 4 dodge, blitz, and scatter the ball, I'm guessing. Double dodge, gets 2 twos, finds the power on the killer. Mighty blow. He's out. Ball is scattered. Will we see magnet hands? We see magnet hands on the most unlikely player. Ogre Boy catches it. This is great news for Brog. Terrible, terrible news for the humans. I mean, for the elves, not the humans. Because he's now a 3+ handoff away from being back in it. He's going after the... Actually, he's gonna cage this piece, and he's gonna blitz this piece into here. Probably with this guy could do it. And then he just has to hand off. He's got the reroll. One reroll. Needs a 3+. He's probably going to go up this way. Nope, it's going to knock him into here. Head up to the right. He's got the pieces. He has to do the handoff first, though. Obviously. And not fail. Oh, rerolls the bonehead and fails the catch. Broggy will be livid about that. Yeah, that is the key. So he rolled one on the bonehead. Loner 5 for the reroll. Bonehead 6. And then he failed catch with catch by rolling 2 twos. The whole point of this piece is to catch the ball, and he failed. All because the stupid ogre was in charge. Dodgy. Gets the power. He's going for a scatter, but he doesn't need to. Will we see a second magnet hands? Nope. Ooh, no. See, that was a heck of a lot of dice for that hit. One on the dodge, 3, a 5, a GFI, another 5. Then he got a 6 and a 5 for the powers. On the Rackle, the Dodge wrestle piece. He's got the ball, he's away! Can anything go wrong? He just has to dodge. Oh, he's just putting it straight in, not even mucking around. Yeah, fire him. So, Broggy down. 0-1 on his drive. But, I think he still has... Oh, all the elves come back. I think... Okay, Brog's got two turns. So, he's more than capable of actually getting a touchdown here. He has a movement 8. And this movement 9 with Agi. You know... If Brog wants to put it in, he can put it in. That's what she said. So he's going to set up for the 2-turn. Gonna mean taking a few hits without a reroll, but he does have the built-in. You try not to let your inner 12-year-old come out. Well, it's too late now. There's only so much you can do. Oh, high kick will help. He's good chances of catching this. He's going for a 1-turn as well. He's going to put catch under it. Which pays off. He got it. Rerolled the 3 into a 4. Going for a handoff. Alright. Okay, so what's the go here? He pushes into here. He's got no sidestep here actually. Pushes here, blitzes. Okay, we're not going for a 1-turn. Done. Ties up some elves. He's gone on the side with the 2 sidestep. lodge. Can't live with it. Can't do anything to bloody well stop it. Getting more push powers than he has powers. So how close he only needs to be here or here. That's 10. So ideally he wants to come up into, he's gonna come into here. This, nope. Another arm break, just a stun. Trouble is that Brog is still a touchdown down. So he really, really needs this equalizer. But then he's still got the trouble of stopping these elves from scoring, which is never easy with elves. Can't help Broggy out though. He always has a plan. Yeah, it's a heck of a gauntlet to run here. But got the edgy four. No rerolls. We got tackle in the worst spot. I don't know. I couldn't tell you what you should do here. I mean, my instinct would be if he had him here. Oh, he's got guard here. He's sending the freaking ogre. Mighty blow. Puts him on the ground just to stun. It's still too far to go for the catcher though. Oh no, he can make it. He just has to get these two players out of the way. And then dodge through here. He's doing the math. Yep. Move the lineman. 34 seconds. Dodge gone. Oh, he's gonna go for it. He's gonna go for it.
He moves up.
Well done. Pop the dodge. We'll have a look at the numbers. Okay, we can back. So there's gonna be players up. Let's have a look here. So he rolled a 3. Rerolled, 4 plus, got 4, it was a 50-50. 2 plus dodge, got a 5, and then the 3 GFIs, 2, 2, and 4, got the touchdown. He has sprint, but he doesn't have sure feet, so, yeah. A 1 would have ended it all. Now we get to see a response. Brog setting up an anti one turn defense. Probably little chance, shy of maybe a quick snap or a riot that the MRM can get a touchdown here, but he also doesn't need to take the risk. He has the full 8 turns to take this as a 2-1 victory. Although, Brog still has the 1 turn, so he could equalize it very easily on turn 16. Thinks he's found a way. I'd say he's setting up for the riot. More than likely. He has no reroll, you know. Okay, he's got a reroll now. Two SPP away from a pass from a level. Two pass farms. Nice and easy. Ooh.
Ooh.
KO. Yes. Insert some guard. Shame he didn't take the blitz first with the mighty blow. And then take a crack with the blockless hit after that. Ooh, finds an injury. So unless the KO, oh, what that means is that Brog has to field his one turner and his agi piece, which is important because MRM is going to be looking to take out those very pieces. Will the KO come back? It does make a difference. Good to know. So it's 10v9. Elves drive. Currently looking at a draw. Hmm. All right, some double and second guessing here on how to set up his team. Left his sides open, allowing for MRM to score quickly if he wants, which is probably the bait. Brog would love for an early touchdown. But the strategy, best strategy here would be for the elves to buy time and try and remove those key players while keeping the ball safe. One less turn, they have to fight it out. Conversely, one less turn for the elves to kill for one turn. Imirim has the dub. I have faith in all elves. It's not that the elves can't do the job. It's that the one turn can undo any work that the elves... The elves can get the touchdown. 100% can get the touchdown. There's no way they can't get the touchdown. Can they stop Brog from getting the touchdown on turn 16? Nah, the only way to do that reliably is to eliminate the one turner. Still a lot can go wrong. There's still a stack of 1-9s ready to go. This guy's going into here. Same difference. Don't know where he's going to do with this one. Here we go. Just a piece in the backfield just to be a pain. Sure hands? The armor was dubbed one, so... Now he's got sure hands. The sacker is a rackle, so, I mean, he's got no strip ball. Alright, elves take four of them for a two die, so sadly defense is a little more rough on us. It's pretty easy for Brog. He's just this dude. I mean, he could blitz a piece like this, but he just takes shots at the easy hits. Eliminate another lineman. Or maybe this rackle piece. It doesn't matter. Just hit something. Actually, yeah, blitz this elf so you can push him into here for follow-up hits. Like, he might be able to force a mistake out of the elves, but again, he can't stop the elves from getting a touchdown. They can score whenever they like. That's a ballsy move. So he's blitzing the sidestepper with the killer. And he's got to hope that he doesn't fail to get him down. It's also a frenzy 2D into a 1D. Here we go. Finds a pal. Yep. Piles on. Definitely piles. Actually, he can't pile on if he wants to protect his one turner. It's still not protected. This is your blitz right here. Looking at the stall. This piece does not have dodge, so he can't pull off the same BS. There goes the reroll. Now he's got a pass. Back to here. Oh, he's going to the Nerves of Steel. Easy. Okay, he's going for an early touchdown. He has to be. Done. I mean, it made sense. Minimal risk, though, you know, he did blow a reroll in the end on the dodge. KO for Brog comes back. I guess he's decided to put it in Brog's court and see if the humans will make another mistake.
Oh.
Alright, what happened? What happened on the kickoff event? Probably nothing important. Alright. Thrower has the ball. Movement 8. Is there anywhere he can't get to? No block on the ogre. Can't make use of that skull power. He's trying to decide if he frees up the lineman or takes another block. Decides to complete the cage. The kill is right here. No dice. Gonna have a very light screen. So Brog has more than enough guard to attack this strength 4 piece. And he'll take both dodges here. One from the lineman, one from the journey. Rolls a 1. Oof. KO. Doing Brog's job for him. So both teams still have their Apo. And Marion with the fame. Trying to decide what he wants to do here. Is that another elf removed? Yes, it was. And KO'd. Guard piece. Humans exerting dominance. No expense spared to protect the killer. He could still blitz that thing. Has the 2 catches. MRM just way low on players. It's a heck of a long receiver. He's just keeping them far away from the strength four tackle, mighty blow, blitzer. Protect his best assets. Well, it looks like we're going to put some sidestep on the ball. Nope. Oh, yeah. Yeah, double dodge. Oh, no. Going for the other corner. Stuns him. Sidestep on the ball. He only needs to fill one space to actually make that, to remove them. Dodge, saving the day. Interesting setup he's done. So he's got an elf ring around the humans, which separates the path between the catcher and the thrower. He can't open the ring up and remove the sidestepper off the elf. I mean, off the... It sends in the killer. Could be brutal. Mighty God, this will be a piling on. You better believe it. The question is, does he go here? Or does he go here? Right, he thinks that Brog is going to move to the right. Or something, I don't know. This is piling on, surely. Just a stun. But by not going here, it means that he can move to the left. Some ways. He can't move far to the left, but he can move to the left. He can't comfortably stay here. Well, that's not true. He could just put... No, he's still not safe. Alright, yep. Assuming this works. Here we go. Okay, so he's... Now he has his cage right where he left it, right here in the center. He could just put the thrower here, reposition the ogre. We may be seeing a foul here. Ooh, that's not safe. And this is where the Brog ruthlessness comes out. And you'll see it. And it will often end badly for you. Okay, Apo saves him. We will see the strength four blitzer back. The star, Benjen. He has, Apo has saved him many a time. Last time from death. Alright, scoring threats in place. It looks like Brog is going to just play for a comfortable draw. But the Pro Elves still have a good chance of stopping that from happening. Question is, how do you attack this? So, what do we got? Movement 6. You can't get in there. It's going to slip in the guard. So, he has a blitz on the ball, but how? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So, one, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So this is a guard. So it's not really... He could cage dive. That's still not good enough because he's got... That's a one die. Oh wait, this is a, yeah, he's a strength 3. Alright, we're doing a dodge, cave dive, doesn't make it. It's a 5 plus that one. Trying to tie up players now. Cross his fingers and hope blodge step. He sees some good blodge step removal. I mean, blodge step action. Just like he did earlier. Problem is that eventually you start rolling sixes. Goes after the sure hands, gets the pal. Stuns him. Piling on? Probably. Doesn't need to. Brog won't. Okay. Yep, forms a new cage. Play. Alright, I'll be back.
Yeah.
Alright, boys and girls, let me just quickly check the stats for you. It was a draw in the end, 2-2. Wow. 7 KOs, 3 injuries for the Wanderers. Black Crows managed 2 KOs and 1 injury from their 23 blocks. Couple of stats. Some powers and some pushes. Black Crows, here's what we're looking for. 31% armor. Some terrible armor. Decent dice what he did.